Ruth here, and this is the Wizarding World Loot Crate, buy a Loot Crate, subscription box. See, it says, hashtag Wizarding World Crate. And as you see, I took off the sticker because I don't like cutting them, I like keeping them. And this is the sword and hat this time. Just put the sticker off to the side for a bit. And let's see what we got here. Ooh. And as you see, obviously my house is Slytherin. So obviously you get Slytherin themed goodies. Very nice box. Let's see, what is the paper saying? Oh, I feel... I think it. Oh, ooh, and if you didn't notice, they actually changed it, because we didn't have this logo before. So, very nice change. Let me just move my bedside table back a bit. There. It can stay open. That's very nice. And, there. Hogwarts House Pride 2018. Whether you're a brave Gryffindor, clever Ravenclaw, loyal Hufflepuff, or cunning Slytherin, represent your house with this Hogwarts House Pride crate. New for 2018. Full of items for all occasions. So it's got the magical blind ball. And it seems this stuff is mainly wearable things, which is slightly iffy here. Okay. So it is pretty cool. Look at that. It's got a little snake here. Obviously, it's got some chain. This is awesome. So, well, better view of the snake there. This is awesome snake. Sweet. And also, as you see, Roman numerals. Just a plain kind of optical illusion type of design there. But what I like most is the click. Yeah. Anyway, that's cool. After we adjust the time if I'm actually going to use it, but yeah. That was probably just mainly, you know, for display purposes, because I suck at reading Roman numerals. Or different analog clocks. That's what I prefer, digital clocks. Or just use my phone, because it numbers that I can read fast. And it's 12-hour, not 24-hour. Anyway, so let's look at the shirt. Obviously, we create exclusive. You got a lot of things. It's very nice they don't have a tag, because those are itchy sometimes. Sweet. We have Slytherin with the snake. It's a very basic t-shirt this time. We have socks. Two pairs. Sock size 10 to 13. I'm not sure if these are a bit big on me, maybe? I don't know. I just don't know if I'd wear them, because I don't want to mess them, you know? And I do get holes in my socks quite often. But here is the Hogwarts Crest sock. And here is the Slytherin crest sock with the word Slytherin along the feet. And these don't have anything on the feet, it's just gray. So it is pretty cool that it's socks, but looks like most of this is wearable stuff, as I said before. And here is a patch. So, I guess you peel it off or something? And iron it, or You just aren't. Anyway, Slytherin crest. Snitch, up there. And Quidditch Hoops with two sort of players right there. I mean, that's pretty cool. You know, for collecting type of thing, but I wouldn't actually really put it on my shirt, I don't think. And lastly, the pin. Which. Is the continuation of a Horcrux pin. Which, if you. Guys, before we still have Nagini and Harry left, I think. Maybe another one, I'm not sure. But those two are left. And I said it's probably a snake for Nagini and maybe the glasses or the lightning bolt, probably, because that's where the Horcrux is behind the lightning bolt. So let's see which one it is, shall we? And we have. Doink. Lightning bolt, enamel pin. And why it's in another language, I have no idea. But, yes. Awesome. Neither can live while the other survives. I think that says can because the C is in the N is kind of not on it properly, but yeah. Slightly disappointed that it's not, you know, printed or whatever on the pin as clear as maybe some others, but yeah, that is awesome. And I did call it. It is a lightning bolt. It's awesome. So I will put these Harry Potter pins on the new cork board that I got, which is over there. Right now, it just has my Pokemon pins on. But I will get around to putting up Harry Potter ones, or I'll just buy another cork board to put those on. But I don't have as many Harry Potter pins as I do Pokemon pins. I don't know. I might put these just at the bottom or in the corner. Yeah. Anyway, I'm rambling now. But yes. So we've got Z pin. So pin, badge, socks. Ignore it, please. And a pocket watch. Oh, and the shirt. So that. Whoa. Is the loot. Obviously the house, you get your own house coordinated socks, shirt, patch, and pocket watch. The only thing that you get the same is the pin and the Hogwarts socks. So let's go through this, shall we? Harry Potter enamel pin. Lord Voldemort made 8 Horcruxes. Though only 7 of them were intentional. Our exclusive Horcrux pin series continues with Harry Potter's infamous scar. Then let's see, the crest Hogwarts crest socks and that Hogwarts house crest socks are the only two items that are not Loot Crate exclusive. So, wise headmaster once said, one can never have enough socks. And these are so nice, I don't really want to wear them. For honoring these words by including 2 pairs, this one featuring Hogwarts school crest. Show off your house print, spirit, can't read, and keep your feet warm and toasty in these colorful socks emblazoned with your house crest. Okay, so Hogwarts house t-shirt, embody the strength and power of your house's mascot in this stylish tee. House patch, add a pop of house pride to your scarf, cloak, or other magical accoutrement. Okay, I've never actually used that word before. With this embroidered house patch and a pocket watch, this intricate carved metal pocket watch features your house mascot on the face and outside. Wear it as a watch or as a necklace and never be late again. That kind of reminds me of the scene with the McGonagall and Very nice to black and blue. McGonagall and when Harry and Ron are late for the first time, was it? She threatened to turn them into a pocket watch. So that is everything. To be honest, I'm slightly disappointed. It's mainly wearable things. But at least it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It does say 5 to 7. It says 4 to 6, but it used to say 5 to 7. But it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Thanks. So, okay, I guess. Slightly disappointed, as I said, because it's all wearables, and I love the pin. That's obviously my favorite, seconded to the pocket watch. But otherwise, it's more on the iffy side this time. And for like £39, it's a little meh. I got the website up now. They do have a slightly different web page. They updated it or something. So they actually did highlight the dates where it's delivered every other month. So by the way, this is the May box. Even though it's right when I'm recording it, it's the 2nd of June. And it does say it should have come between the 15th and 25th of the month. But I'm guessing since this is, might be international postage, maybe? Or just, they're just a bit late. Post people. Because the shipping details did come quite a while ago, so. I chalk it up to distance, I guess, for this one. Let's see. So like, January, March, May, July, September, November, then all over again. So yay, I should be able to get the next box is in July, which is in my birthday month, so that's very nice. And the next theme is magical creatures. Feathers, fur, scales, wings, fangs, the magical creatures of the Wizarding World take many wondrous forms. This collection celebrates the many creatures and beasts that have captured our imaginations, from dragons to nifflers. Ends at the 3rd of July, 9 p.m. Pacific time, I guess that's what it says. Supplies are limited, so that means buy yours by that time. And obviously you can, you got different plans, which is, you know, 1 crate, 3 crate, 6 crate. And for UK, £39. So like, for 1 crate, obviously it's 39. And 3, you'll get a 3 and 6, you'll get a discount, I'm guessing. You choose your house, so they know which ones to tailor you to, and you choose your shirt size. But that is basically it. On their website, they do have, like, you know, previous box pictures if you want to have a look-see. And yeah, I need to update my crate picture because they on my thumbnail now. Yay! That's it. So thank you for watching. Why don't you leave a comment down below, which one was your favorite item? Mine, obviously, I said, are those two. And yeah, that's where you, do you think this box was worth it? Do you think you're happy with this box? A bit of a letdown, good thing, just, you know, whatever. How do you think of the change? I think it is a pretty cool change, actually. It does look a bit more snazzy-like. So thank you for watching. Thanks for watching. Over and out. By the way, in the description below, there is a reference, a referral link to this site in general, I think. Anyway, it's in the description. You get some money off, I think. Can't really quite remember, but it saves you something, I think. Doodles!